type that is utilizing pulse oximeters that is present in today's variables for measuring pH value in sweat. So the advantage of our work is it is real-time and continuous, and it is long-term reusable, and it can be compatible with all existing smartwatches or fitness trackers with pulse oximeters in them. So as all our smartwatches have like heart rate sensors, similarly, nowadays you can see pulse oximeters being embedded into most of the smartwatches. The purpose of pulse oximeter is to measure your oxygen concentration. So like lots of devices, basically Fitbit Charge 3, Garmin Vivo Smart, and Withings pulse oximeter watch all have embedded pulse oximeter in it. So the how does a pulse oximeter work is basically it helps you measure the oxygen saturation. So it shines two lights, red light at 660 nanometer and infrared light at 880 nanometer. It shines light through your finger, and the sensors detect how much oxygen is present in your blood through the reflection. Basically, a well-known sensor for measuring pH value of any solution. So how does it work is basically for low pH values, the polymer gets protonated and there is strong transmission of red light and strong absorption of IR light. For high pH, the polymer gets deprotonated and it absorbs red light at 660 nanometer, and there is strong transmission of IR light at 880 nanometer. The advantage of this polymer is because it is reusable and it is of very low cost, like it's less than $1, so it can be attached to any watch with pulse oximeter, and it is biocompatible and it does not disintegrate. So this is the transmission for different values of pH from a polyaniline sensor. I'll refer polyaniline to PANI during the talk. So in the PANI sensor, for infrared light, there is an increase in the transmission, and for red light, there is a decrease in the transmission. We can make use of this ratio and calibrate to get the pH value of sweat. So how we calibrated the pH value using IR red ratio, because we used Max 30101 pulse oximeter from Maxim Integrated, which is a commercial pulse oximeter for wearables. And we mounted it with polyaniline pH sensor, and we made synthetic sweat solutions of different pH levels, 200 microliter, and we measured the reflected IR and red ratios and calibrated the IR red ratio curve for human pH range of 3 to 8. So the high level overview of our pH watch is basically pulse oximeter is mounted with polyaniline pH sensor, and then it is the pulse oximeter sends the data through I2C to the CC2650 sensor tag, which is basically a microcontroller and with different sensors like accelerometers, barometers, etc. And the sensor tag processes the signals and produce and gives the pH value, heart rate, and SpO2. Once the data is collected, we first do the pH sensing approach, which will be discussed later, and then we remove motion artifact from the signal, because the main purpose of this application is during exercise, so we need to remove motion artifact from the PPG signals to get accurate heart rate and SpO2 signal, and finally we get pH, heart rate, and SpO2. So this is the overall system prototype of pH watch. So the skin and then the sweat on the skin, the polyaniline sits directly on the skin, and then the Max 30101, and then Max 30101 is connected to a CC2650 microcontroller sensor tag, and then we can either connect it to a LCD display or through BLE we can transmit to the mobile phone. So we have our own pH sensing algorithm. So what happens is we cannot just use the raw infrared and red values, because a typical PPG signal reflected from a pulse oximeter looks like this. So there is a huge DC component, and in the top you can see alternating AC component. So the AC component corresponds to your heart rate, but the reflection from the polyaniline part of the PPG signal. One is reflection from tissue and sweat, which is constant, and reflection from non-pulsatile arterial blood, and reflection from pulsatile arterial blood, and the final component is the reflection from your Fani film, which is the pH sensor. So we are only interested in the reflection from the polyanilin sensor. So we need to separate out the reflection other than that. So we, before beginning the pH calculation, before exercise, the user has to initialize the DC component of his skin without sweat, so that you can only get the reflection from the skin. And every time when you sweat and when you need to calculate pH, we separate out the initialized value, DC value, from the calculated DC value to get the polyanilin's reflection. And by this, you can get the DC component of polyanilin. Both the red signal and the IR signal, and from that you can calculate the ratio DC of IR and DC of red. So which will, again, we can use the calibration curve that we made earlier to decode them to the pH values. So another major challenge for us is we need to make sure that it does not affect the existing capability of pulse oximeter to measure heart rate and SpO2. Heart rate is affected by motion artifacts. For example, this is your heart rate, which is very simple. So basically, your heart rate is the number of peaks per minute. But when you are moving or when you are running, even with mild or green PPG signal. Then after DC removal and after bandpass filtering, because we only concentrate in the 0.4 to 4 hertz, because your heart rate occurs only in that range. The maximum is like 4 hertz. And then after troika removal, you can get more cleaner heart rate with signal with which you can easily measure heart rate. For SpO2 measurement, SpO2 is basically, as I told, like previously, the ratio of red and infrared. So the ratio of red is AC red by DC red and AC infrared by DC infrared. Both the AC components we get from the cleansed PPG signal that we obtained using TRICA. But we cannot directly tell R is equal to SpO2 because there is no direct relationship between the red and the infrared lights, because their scattering constant and the optical path length of red and infrared change a lot. So we need experimental calibration, like we repeat the experiments with multiple people, like each device has their own calibration function, like they do it with multiple participants and find out a formula, like SpO2 for max 30101 is 104 minus 17R. And for our experiments, for heart rate, we asked a single participant to wear a pH watch, and for each trial, we calculated the heart rate for 120 seconds at different times of day. And the ground truth values are measured by a finger pulse oximeter. In the first experiment, we did not ask the participant to make any motion, and we calculated the values from pH watch and the values from max 30102 ground truth pulse oximeter, and we obtained a worst case error of 3.44%, and the mean error was around 1.22%. And similarly, for the next experiment was with random hand motions. Like, we asked the participant to make as many motions as possible. And here the same, each trial was for 120 seconds. So pH watch was worn in the right hand and the left hand was left stationary so that it does not get affected by motion, the ground truth heart rate measurements. And at the same time, we measured the heart rate from both the participants. The best case error was 2.78 and the worst case was 6.41%. The average error was around 5%. So for SpO2, similarly, we did two experiments without hand motion and without motion. For without any hand motion, we measured an error of around 2.04% and a worst case error of 3.22%. And the mean error was around 2.75%. With random hand motions, the error was 2.12% best case and 6.73% worst case. And the mean error was around 4.57%. So for pH measurements, we made two experiments. First experiment was with six participants and they were asked to exercise for 10 to 20 minutes and they were made to sweat. And after sweating, we measured the ground truth with Halo wireless pH meter and we measured the pH with pH watch, and the results were like, we repeated the experiments two times for each participant. So the worst case pH error was around 0.4% and the best case pH error was around 4.2% with an average error of around 2.31%. So basically we had a pH error of around plus or minus 0.2 to 0.3. And another experiment, we wanted to test the continuous sensing capability of heart rate, SpO2 and pH with the error of pH occurring when you do exercise. So the previous one was stationary, this one was when doing exercise. So we hired four participants and we made them exercise for 80 minutes and the ground truth value was measured by Halo wireless pH meter every 5 minutes during the experiment, because the pH value does not change rapidly within 5 minutes or 10 minutes. So we used the value that is measured every 5 minutes for the next year. And for continuous sensing results, like you can see the heart rate, SpO2, the pH value increases as the participant increases because during exercise you get dehydrated. So the maximum pH error that we obtained was around plus or minus 0.6. And as you can see, for all the four participants, during exercise, as the participant starts to exercise without drinking water, the pH value increases a lot, increases rapidly, like from stage to stage every 10 minutes, which means that the dehydration risk is increasing and decrease in the hydration levels is occurring. The limitations are like, we had very limited participants, like 10 participants. So we need to test it with different skin types. And also we did not study the effect of sweat residue that remains on the skin. The worst case SpO2 error was around 7%. So we still need to get it reduced less than 5% for FDA approval. And we also need to study the patterns in pH values to get a more trustworthy dehydration risk. So to conclude, like, pH watch is basically the first ever off-the-shelf addition of polyaniline to leverage pulse oximeters that are present in existing wearables to sense pH value, which will give you an accurate measure of your dehydration. And the addition of PANI does not affect the heart rate and SpO2 measurement, and it is a very low cost polymer, and it can be added to any smartwatch with pulse oximeters. So the next goal of our research is to acquire more data and analyze patterns in pH values to get a more absolute value for dehydration risk.